in the midst of his people. Wherever two or three gather in the name of the Lord, he said, there he is in the midst. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He's in the midst of our storm. He's in the valley we walk through. Where two or three are gathered in his name, he'll be there too. Sitting in a chair, and he said, you was just so low, didn't think you could touch the Lord, didn't think you was hearing from God. But he said, I just want you to know, the whole time you sitting there, the Lord was standing right there beside you. And the Lord turned and said to this missionary brother, when he came in that door by the Spirit, he said, you see him? And the man said, yes, I see him. He said, I have spoke to him in almost a year. I let him feel a thing on his flesh, but said every morning he gets up and comes in this room and gets in this chair and by faith declares, Lord, I know that I have your presence. I know that I have your glory. He said, you see him, said he's on that chair. Said if he is at all, if he is trying to fall off that chair, he said, I'd have him before he ever hit the floor and I'd put him right back there. But he said, look at him. Said he's so dedicated to me that I haven't let his flesh feel a thing, but he knows in his spirit. That how many know if your flesh feels it wonderful, but if it don't feel it, there's still a presence of God that is continuously in your life. Let me tell you something, folks. In the storm, when you're trying to feel something, that doesn't have anything to do with whether or not the Lord is working in our behalf. Oh, it's wonderful. I'm not denying feeling. I feel something this morning already, but I'm telling you, even when I don't feel it like I want to feel it, I still have to raise my hands and glorify God because he's faithful. Let me ask you a question. How faithful are you? Not just, I'm not talking about coming to church and all that stuff. I'm talking about in your heart. Well, glory to God. Is your Christian walk fair weather? Is it only up when you're up and things is up? Or are you one of them who can stand in the middle of it all and raise your hands to heaven and say, this is a day the Lord has made and I will rejoice and be glad. Let me tell you something. Look up here and listen. Your pastor love on you a little bit and give you some good information. It won't change till you do. So somebody today is going to make a change. And when they do, something around you is going to start changing. But it ain't in the Lord's hand to change. It's in our hand. We got power in our mouth this morning to speak the word of the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. I feel the anointing here. I feel the presence of God in our midst. I feel the Spirit of the Lord wanting to move for somebody today. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, this day is the day the Lord hath made. Glory to God. I made a choice. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. God bless you today. Say, this is not guesswork and it's not mind over matter. This is a thing already decreed and decided in thy behalf this day, saith the Lord. I have decreed victory out of my own mouth, and I have spoken it unto thy spirit this day, and know that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of my mouth this day, saith the Lord. I have spoken and decreed wellness and victory over thee, and yea, I would say unto thee this day, align thy tongue with my word, and align thy thoughts with my word this day, saith the Lord, and ye shall see a pattern unfold before your very eyes, for I will cause much to fall into place. Hallelujah. I will cause difficult things to become very easy. I will cause that which is complicated to be just a drop of the bucket. I will cause your eyes to be open to a whole new level of understanding, saith the Lord. For my desire this day is not only to pick thee up on the outer court, but to pick thee up within thyself this day and to set thee in the high places of my glory and show thee my great and mighty acts, saith the Lord God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
How many believe this morning that the Spirit wants to take you to houses you've not built?
Amen.
Vineyards you've not planted? Amen. Come on. To a lifestyle that you've not worked for. We're going to start a new series this morning. And we're going to call this thing Possession of Your Confession. And I don't know how long, and I really don't care how long we're on it. And I really don't care if it seems redundant at times. Because what we're going to do is we're going to receive this stuff in our heart, not our head. Because that's where change comes from. Comes from the heart. It's where deliverance comes from. It comes from the heart. And we release this stuff that we receive in our heart through what we say. So you can subtitle it if you want. You can have what you say. Okay? So we're going to walk through scripture. We're going to walk through stories. We're going to do things. You know what I'm saying? I mean, because we're going to, and listen to me. Don't try to make sense out of it. Don't try to receive it in your head because it don't work that way. But I want to start by saying that to live by faith is to live by the supernatural. And when we talk of living by the supernatural, we're talking about living beyond the senses. You see, you got to come to this lifestyle, to this understanding that God's intention for you, His will for you, lifestyles. And let's start off with, we know that you couldn't save yourselves. Okay? We know that it was by grace, what? Through faith, are we what? Saved. We're saved that way. And when we talk about salvation, I mean, we tend to box that up into this prayer we said one day where we asked Jesus to come into our life. But we're going beyond all that. We're talking about completely rescued. Completely delivered. So it's by grace. In other words, it's not by your effort. You know what I'm saying? It's through faith. You know what I'm saying? It's through our believing that we see the manifestation of this come. So when it comes to, when we're talking about a lifestyle financially, God's desire is to take you beyond what your paycheck can afford. Amen. I'm going to say that again. The will of God is for you to live beyond what your paycheck can afford. Because we're not dealing with that. He just said it. Man shall not live by bread alone. You know what that is? The works of your hands. Now, He's blessed your hands to work. Don't get me wrong. But He's not condensed your lifestyle into that. Now, we know this. Because, let's look, it doesn't matter. It's whosoever. It doesn't matter if you're male. It doesn't matter if you're female. It doesn't matter what color you are. It has nothing to do with what's that. Whosoever. So, listen, in the stories, we could, I mean, it doesn't matter if your husband's passed away and all you guys are a little old pot of oil. Come on, it doesn't matter. What God's called you to lifestyle, He's called you to live, is beyond what you can supply. It's beyond what your paycheck can afford. And I want you to get this because I really think there, you know, and I think we all know this, that last Sunday started a major shift, you know what I'm saying, in our consciousness and our heart. There was a fresh word that was sown into the ground. That was sown into our hearts. Hallelujah. To bring forth a change. You know what I'm saying? To bring forth a change. And that's what we gather here for. To receive a word that will change things in our life. Now, how many knows? The sower sows the word. Someone comes along and waters that word. And God what? Gives increase to that word. So it's vital that we participate in this thing. Because that's what takes place. We want to see change take place in our life. So, glory be to God. So we see a widow woman, not just once, but twice. Okay? So it doesn't matter. We're not talking. It doesn't matter if in the natural you're set on what we would call a fixed income. God is God. And God is our source. Now, not only listen, does He want to take you to a lifestyle? He's designed for you to live. That's what I mean. In a lifestyle financially beyond what your paycheck can afford, He's designed your body to live beyond the realm that any pill, any medication, any new invention, whatever, can do. Okay? So it doesn't matter. Nothing wrong with taking medicine. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is that stuff will not take you to a place that you're designed to live from. Only the Word of God. It is the Word of God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Now, hallelujah. Now what we got to come to understand, I want y'all to go to Matthew chapter 12. Now this lifestyle requires us receiving first the Word in our hearts and believing a word that does not make sense to the natural mind. Yeah. You've got to get it in your head or your heart this morning.
Yeah.
Come on, that the natural mind cannot receive the things of God.
Right.
So the lifestyle that God has designed to live, which we know Habakkuk says that this lifestyle is a faith lifestyle. Faith is not a natural force. Faith is not a natural thing at all.
Amen.
Faith is a spirit.
Yeah.
It is the spirit of faith. Faith is a gift. The gift of faith. Hallelujah. So we're talking about receiving the word. Now remember what Isaiah said and Paul said again in Romans chapter 10. How are they going to hear it unless a preacher comes along and preaches? See, what's bound the church up is that we've taken the Word of God and we brought it into an intellectual word. In other words, we brought it down to a level where our minds can try to comprehend it and make sense out of it. But it was never intended for your natural mind to make sense because it can't make sense out of it.
Amen.
Folks, if it seems too good to be true, guess what? It is the Word of God. Now, you're going to have everything in your head and everyone around you. And sometimes it's the good old believers that are sitting on the pew right next to you, because I've been one of them. And I don't mean 20 years ago. I mean, it could have been 20 minutes ago. That get caught up in what we see. Get caught up in what we hear. Come on, get caught up in your past experience or my past experience. And then we bring the Word of God down to that level. And instead of taking God and taking the Word of God and changing the picture,
right,
we bring God down into the picture and try to change God.
Oh my.
And so it causes us to go around the wilderness and wander in the... Come on, how many know that it was originally an 11-day journey to the promised land, but yet they wandered. They wandered. That's what keeps you in the wilderness. Wondering if God's doing it. Wondering if the Word is true. Wondering if my mouth can't change the circumstance. Wondering if the mountain's really removed. Wondering if the sycamore tree can really be plucked up. Come on. Wondering if I hold fast the confession of my faith. He is faithful that promised it. Come on. Wondering that He is able to do exceeding abundantly above everything my heart could think, everything my mind could desire, everything, come on, that in your natural mind will try to bottle you up in all that.
Yes.
Bottle you up. But according to Hebrews chapter 4, I'm going to read this in the... Which one I got here? The mirror. I got several on us today. How many know that that's where you're talking about, the Word of God is what? Quick.
Yes.
Powerful. Yes. Sharper than a what? Dividing asunder of what? Soul and spirit. Hallelujah. Here's what it says in the Mirror Bible. The message God spoke to us in Christ is the most life-giving and dynamic influence in us. Cutting like a surgeon's scalpel, sharper than a soldier's sword, piercing to the deepest core of human consciousness. How many know that's what we think? To the dividing of soul and spirit, and here's what I want you to get, ending the dominance of the sense realm and its neutralizing effect upon the human spirit. In this way, man's spirit is free to become the ruling influence again in the thoughts and intentions of the heart,
The scrutiny of this word detects every possible disease, discerning the body's deeper secrets where joints and bone marrow meet. Here's what it says. The Word of God is alive.
Yes.
It is a living Word.
Yes.
Oh, you got to get that. Because see, it goes beyond the soul realm.
All right.
The Holy Ghost is a good setup guy. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, this whole prophecy, this whole interpretation just came forth. It goes beyond all that stuff.
Yeah.
It takes you to a lifestyle beyond all
beyond,
that.
Yeah.
See, he started off that chapter saying that the same gospel that has been preached unto the Israelites back in the wilderness days is the same gospel that was preached unto us. We've heard the same message, but let us not be like they were, where they didn't take the message and mix the active ingredient to the message. Which is what? Faith.
Yeah.
Now with them, they had evidence of everything around them. They were getting fed manna every day. They had the pillars of cloud by day, the pillar of fire by night. But yet there was no evidence of faith there.
Right.
Because when it came time to walk into the promised land, what did they say? The giants in there are way too big. We are like grasshoppers in their sight. I mean, you understand that? Because see, how you perceive yourself is how you project yourself. I heard Brother Hagin say this years and years ago, what you say is your faith speaking.
Amen.
See, if you live by faith, it's one way or the other. You know what I'm saying? I mean, now what is fear in? Fear is faith in a bad thing happening that you ain't seen yet. It is the same thing. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You know what I'm saying? So we're talking about that. When faith, we're talking about seeing things in the Word of God. I haven't seen it in the natural, but I know that I got it. Now let me tell you something, folks, and I've experienced it. I'm going to talk about me this morning because it's easier to talk about me. I remember when the inspiration came to go and start the pest control business. That, you know, I had talked to a couple of clients, you know what I mean, and I mean, not asking for help or nothing, but just saying, you know, that I'm thinking about going this way. And these were clients that I was really good friends with over the years, and they were Christian folk, you know what I mean, and things like that. And I remember one man, you know, came up to me and said, "Hey, look, What all you need to start?" And I told him, "I need a trailer. Here's my vision. I want this, that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's what I need. Get up and go, tank, and all this kind of stuff like that." And he comes and he tells me, he says, "Well, you know what, Chris? You let me know how much it's going to be." And I ran with it. Oh, hallelujah. The next month I come to do his lawn, and here I was, I'm a month closer. I mean, I'm literally a couple weeks away from giving my notice, you know what I'm saying? I mean, because I'd already took the test and all that stuff, which that was a hassle within itself. Because, in, you know what I'm saying, in the natural, you go on the website and you look, and it says if you've been convicted of a felony, you can't go get a license.
All right.
And I remember when I first seen that, I'm sitting there sweating like, whoa, whoa, but I knew God had placed something in my heart. And so right now, I said, "Well, if he's giving it to me, then he must be going to blot all this stuff out." So I just put it in the hand of the blood and said, "Look, you've washed all that stuff away."
Yeah.
So there ain't no, I mean, who's a convicted felon?
Yeah. Right.
Come on. Yeah. Who has a record like that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now, in the natural, it's there, but who cares about all that stuff? We're not talking about living by natural means. We're not talking about living by natural experiences. We're talking about plugging into something that goes beyond the natural. When you talk about supernatural, you're talking about going beyond the natural. And God wants to take you to the supernatural. He wants to take you to extraordinary lifestyle. But you got to come out of that old way of thinking that the flesh can limit you. That your past can trap you. Come on. The only thing that can snare you is the words that come out of your mouth. The only thing that gives you life is the words that come out of your mouth. And the only thing that can kill you is the words that come out of your mouth. Can't no man do it. Can't no government do it. Can't no this earth waiting for God to heal them. There ain't nobody on this earth waiting for God to save them, because in one act of righteousness, he took care of it all. There ain't nobody waiting on God to bless them.
No.
But see, God calls those things which be not. You see, faith, let me tell you something, I'm going to be a little cutthroat here for a second. Faith does not talk about what God's going to do. There is no such thing as future faith. Faith, come on, looks at the future and talks about it in past tense. Come on, it takes the promise of God in His Word and talks about it like as if it already happened. I'll give you the example now. Because when in Romans chapter 4 is where Abraham, we talk about Abraham, how God called him Abraham. Now remember, it was Abram, who was just simply father.
Right.
And God comes in there and says, no, you're not Abram. You're Abraham, which changed that to the father of many nations, or a father of a multitude. Now get it, he had a kid.
That's right.
But yet God's calling him Abraham.
Yeah.
Come on, in every city he walks into, when they ask him who he is, he doesn't say Abram.
No.
He says Abraham, and that was without any evidence of Isaac being around. Folks, when someone asks you how you're doing, come on, it is your God-given right to say all is well. I don't care, Sister Sue, I don't care if you got that thing and you're having to breathe. If they ask you how your breathing is, you say, my breathing is absolutely fine. Oh, hallelujah. If someone asks you how your finances is, say, I am above and not beneath. Oh, come on, I am a millionaire. I'm rich beyond my wildest portion. See, we've been sitting here waiting on God to send 1,000 people in this church for this church to do things that it wants to do. But I read in the Word, He said He can deliver by many or He can deliver by few. We don't need 500 people here to build a new sanctuary. We don't need 500 people here to have a new children's church. What we need is 2 or 3 to get together and start believing the 4 crazy, radical, faith-believing, word-standing-on friends that will not try to work out the details of it. Will just receive it in their heart and act on it. That's it. That's it. So we're coming out. Woo!
Glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, son. Hallelujah. 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 For God was saying to you, I have not only brought you out by my word, but now I bring you in by my word. I've not brought you out just out of sickness, but I brought you into health. I've not just brought you out of lack, but I brought you into wealth. And I've not just brought you out of death, but I brought you into life. And you shall see the scenery change. And you shall hear the conversation change. And you shall see buildings erect. And you shall see foundations go up. Hallelujah, for the word has been spoken, it, and I'm faithful to my word, says the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you something about the message of sonship I've come to find out over the last couple of weeks. If it don't cause you to believe, it ain't sonship.
Yes, that's right.
A lot of folk talking about running around with the sonship message and don't believe a thing. Come on, ain't used faith in 20 years.
Yes, sir.
think it's not even there. But you remember we went through this in the book of Ruth when Obed was born, which is sonship.
Come on,
which is the man child. And she took that thing and she put it in Naomi's lap. That which had been dead came to life. Come on. That which had said, I have no more son in me. I have no more life in me. There's not another movement of God in me. There's not another revival in me. Then she said all that stuff. But the minute that message hit her bosom, hit her, come on, she received it into her womb. Guess what happened? It said she immediately began to nurse that baby. That word nurse in the Hebrew is the Hebrew word for faith, folks. The true message of sonship will resurrect the spirit of faith. It ain't going to cause you to sit down. It ain't going to cause you to just say, well, it is what it is. It's whatever. Come on. It's going to change all that.
Yes.
Change all that.
Amen.
Say, we coming out. Come on, say it. We coming out. We coming out of sickness. We're coming out of lack. We're coming out of death. But we ain't just coming out. We're coming in. We're coming into divine health. We're coming into divine wealth. And we're coming into divine life.
Hallelujah.
And I don't care if we're the only building on the block or in the city. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Come on. They can't nobody limit us. Hallelujah. Folks, I'm telling you, I was in that thing. I had to start that thing by faith. The man comes to me, here I am, I done took the test, and I had to go through hell with that, you know what I'm saying? I mean, the boss man didn't want to sign off. The boss man is sending me text saying, are you sure you want to do this? Because you got a felony record. And this wasn't a stranger either. Come on. Wasn't a stranger either. And my response was, well, I guess I am. I said, I just got one thing to rely on, my faith in the mercy of God. That's it. That's it. So in the meantime, when all this is going on, all of a sudden I go to spray the guy's lawn. The guy comes out and said, I mean, he was an older gentleman. He said, Chris, I just want to let you know something. He said, you know, my mama, well, she was really old. Can I take a turn for the worse? And we're going to have to, you know, probably help out, maybe financially help her out some and stuff like that. So I'm going to have to pull back. You know, I ain't going to give you no money. And he had a trailer that he was going to basically give to me. He said, no, I ain't going to be able to give you a trailer. And I'm like, okay. All right. My mind wanted to tell me, well, what are you going to do? How are you going to start this thing? You done stepped out there now. This is the avenue you thought it was going to come, and all of a sudden it ain't there. What was happening? My mind was trying to tell me without that man. Come on, without that man.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
I couldn't do it. So I remember I had to work on a Saturday, and I was out there, and I think it was Ruskin somewhere, something like that, Riverview. And I'm spraying that lawn, and I'm just, you know, by this time I had, you know, listened to Bill Winston's Law of Confession CDs probably 1,000 times, if not, you know, once, you know, and Hagin and Faithful. But you got to feed your spirit, folks. Listen, let me tell you something about the Word of God. You want your faith to grow. It grows by the Word of God, folks. That's it. That's it. Come on now. The Scripture says, build up your most holy faith by praying the Spirit. Guess what? When you pray in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit is praying the Word of God. Don't get it twisted. The Holy Spirit ain't praying about you being sick. The Holy Spirit ain't praying about you not having money. Come on. He ain't praying about you not having divine health. What he's doing is agreeing with what the Word of God says about you. The Holy Ghost is calling you an overcomer. The Holy Ghost is calling you blessed. See, Come on. He's correcting all that nonsense you've been freaking out of your mouth probably all the time. Come on. You try to bring you being sick to God. What's God going to call you? Healed. He's going to call you well. You come up to him talking about how you don't have nothing. What's he going to call you? Come on. He's going to call you abundant. He's going to call you an overcomer. You come on. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Oh, come on. You better go with me now. I'm just trying to tell you something. We're going off into the supernatural. We're going to do it by just believing the word of God. We're just going to do it by believing the word of God. So here we go. You know what I'm saying? All this stuff. Well, I'm spraying this lawn, and all of a sudden I get a vision of me pushing a spreader. And in my old little truck and spraying with backpacks. And I said, okay. You know, that ain't the way I thought it was going to start out. But if that's what you want to show me, that's okay. Now, I started out that way. I ain't having to do it that way now.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, there was even times, I mean, I get this account that's about 30,000 square feet. And you're talking about only putting 4 gallons of something in a backpack, and that 4 gallons ain't going to do but 4,000 square feet. And I'm having to keep going over there and fill that backpack up, but I'm doing it with a smile on my face. Woo, I tell you, because I know he showed me that was where I was going to begin, but I know it wasn't going to stay. See, I knew even the backpack couldn't keep me back. I knew even just the spreader couldn't keep me down because I had the word of the Lord on my heart. Woo, and a good man out of the good treasures of his heart bringeth forth good things. Go there. I'll tell y'all to go there. Matthew chapter 12. Let's look at it. I'm telling you, man, look at the person next to you and tell them you're going. Coming out. Now look back at him again and say, and you're going in. Ain't that what he told Moses and them? He said, I brought you out, folks. I brought you out to bring you in. I didn't bring you out to leave you wondering whether or not I'm God. I didn't bring you out to leave you wondering if you're a kingdom of priests unto me. I didn't bring you out to keep you wondering where your next paycheck's coming from. I didn't bring you out to keep you wondering where your next meal's coming from. I didn't bring you out to keep you wondering where your new car's coming from. I didn't bring you out to keep you wondering where the new sanctuary is coming from. Oh, he brought you in. He brought you out to bring you into a place of faith where you ain't working for this no more. Oh, you ain't running and sweating and eating the right thing every second of the day to try to get this thing. You're receiving the word of the Lord into your heart, and a good man out of the good treasure of his heart, he brings forth good things. Say good things. Ooh. Either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt.
That's right.
And its fruit corrupt. For the tree is known.
That's right.
By his fruit. Let me tell you something. If I got a bunch of oranges sitting over here, what kind of tree I got? If I got a bunch of apples up here, what kind of tree I got? Come on, if I got some grapefruit in my hand, what kind of tree I got? So if I got lack, what kind of tree I got? Oh, y'all want to got silent right there. Come on, if I got sickness in my life, what kind of tree I got? Understand that now. Let's go on. Old generation of vipers. How can you be an evil speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Here's our verse. A good man, out of the good treasure or deposit now. Well, I think the Amplified says deposit. Treasure of the heart bringeth forth good things. And an evil man, out of the evil treasure, bringeth forth evil things. But I say unto you, that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. Now let's think about this, because what we've been, not necessarily here, but we're talking about in the mainstream of things. We've been taught if we had the right man in office, if we had the right party in office, come on, then we might be able to succeed. And vice versa. If the wrong one's in there, come on, then we can't, come on, succeed in life. Let's go lower it down. If we got the right boss man or boss lady. All right. Come on, if we got the right kind of boss lady in there, then there's no limit to what we can do. But if we have the wrong kind of in there, then we're limited to this. Hold up. Now we're going where your natural mind don't want to go or can't go, to be honest with you. According to this scripture, he says that your destiny is not in someone else's hands. This lifestyle, come on, of the kingdom. We're talking about kingdom here.
Yes.
In the kingdom, there's something called commonwealth.
Yes.
And in the kingdom, there's not social classes.
No, sir.
In the kingdom, it doesn't matter what side of the track you so-called grew up on.
Right. Yes, amen.
Woo! Come on now. I mean, our ancestry made it. Oh, glory be to God. Came up. You know, picking cotton, just living off that. Come on, they may have been living in a little one-room shack somewhere, in come on, and all this stuff like that. But see, that ain't gonna limit me. Oh, come on, I need y'all to go with me. See, that ain't got no bearing on me. Come on, before me, they may have thought that when it come to faith, that just mean believing for one meal at a time, if it was just a can of soup that came through. And they had a limited lifestyle.
Right.
But just because they had a limited lifestyle, doesn't mean I gotta have a limited lifestyle. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. He said, come on, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to what? Them, that's you. Them, that is you. Them, that is me. That is you. Come on, to them that believe. Come on, let me tell you something. I can take a promise of the word, and I can believe on that word, and I can have it whether you believe it or not. Just because you believe don't mean I gotta fall under the same thing. Come on, just because mama and them didn't believe, just because granny and them didn't believe it, just because the generation before them didn't believe it, doesn't mean you got to stay stuck in that same old mentality.
Absolutely. Yes.
We're going.
Yes.
We're coming out.
Amen.
Come on. And I'm here to tell you, he's delivering by many, or he's delivering by few folks. I'll go ahead and put it out there. Elevated Pest Management will be the biggest giver to this church.
All right. Hallelujah.
And this community will be the biggest giver. Get ready.
Hallelujah.
You're going to see the name everywhere.
Amen.
We're going to get involved in everything.
Hallelujah.
Now you didn't take that same confession and say it about you and your family.
Yes.
Come on. I ain't waiting for a millionaire to walk through that door.
Come on.
I'm going to be the one that walks through that door.
Yes, Lord.
Hold up. I'm going to tell you something, folks. I just seen this thing happen in my own business. We went, glory be to God. I didn't even finish the first part of the business, but needless to say, we're here and we're working despite all what people try to say and do. And you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Let me tell you something. I told you that one Wednesday night about, well, I'll start from again. We go up to Alabama for a cheer clinic when the last Hurricane Matthew came through. And so we go up there, and when we get back, I got some friends that are in the construction industry, and what one of the project managers did, he took off over there, and all the construction things are going on, and what they're doing is they got crews cleaning up limbs and all that stuff, and I mean, it was good money. I mean, the cities and the counties over there was paying really good just for folks to come take all this debris and move it to the front of the road, side of the road, out of people's yards, and they just cut a check for you. Well, here I am. I'm just, you know, one-man crew. I ain't got all this stuff. And he's like calling me saying, hey, if you can get the material together, you can get all this stuff like that. And I made some phone calls, you know what I'm saying? Let me tell you what I didn't do first. I didn't go to God about it first and receive and get the promise of God concerning it. So I started calling guys and calling this, you know what I mean? Like, hey, I got this opportunity. You know, one of the guys I work with a lot, he's like, you know, I'm pretty busy. Actually, I'm over here in Vero at some of my accounts right now. I'm busy. And I talked to another guy. He had a crew of guys, but he didn't have, you know, the material and the equipment and all that stuff like that. So I was frustrated about it. And so I found myself in conversations, you know what I'm saying, playing to people like, yeah, you know, I got this vision of expanding and growing, you know what I'm saying? But the problem is I don't have the equipment. I don't have this. I got connections, I mean, and all this stuff like that. And I said, I got to expand this thing to go commercial and stuff like that because in my line of work, you know what I'm saying? I said, because what usually my next customer is usually just a $50 customer or a $100 customer. That's what I'm saying to these folks. This was, what, the second week of October. This is at the beginning of the second week. At the end of the second week, I get a phone call from a guy I had met a year before at a Lowe's parking lot in Davenport, where I just happened to be there because my pull string broke on my motor, and I went to go fix it. I'm out in the parking lot doing it. He just pulls up and says, hey, you do pest control? I said, yes, sir. What all you do? I told him, he said, what's normally your charge? I told him, he said, I run like a vacation home rental place around here. He said, I got, you know, quite a few accounts and stuff. He goes, but I have somebody that I use that we've been using for a while. He's like, just give me a card. And I said, well, here you go. That was a year ago, folks. Here I have been talking. So he calls me and says, hey, Chris, you remember this is Danny? I met you over at Lowe's, and obviously I remember that. He said, I need you to come in and have a meeting with me. He said, I might have a couple accounts for you. Now, let me tell you, my natural mind was thinking two or three accounts. That'd be great. You know what I'm saying to me? But he counts an account. I get over there. When I get over there, he comes walking out of the office. He's toting this piece of paper. Well, I just glance down at a piece of paper, and I see just account after account after account after account just sitting there. We sit down at the table, and he had 35 brand new accounts. Amen. Folks, here I was just trying to convince somebody that the next account I got is only going to be $50 or $100. And God shows up and says, what are you talking about, $50 or $100? I can just give you $1,000 in a day. Come on, a good man out of the good treasure in his heart brings four good things. What is the good things? The good things are the word of God. What are the evil things? Some God never said to begin with. The Amplified says in verse 37, or Message Bible says, Eminem's on the move. Sometimes that's just depressing. But I'm having fun this morning. Hallelujah. I ain't even got past the first little part here, so we're good. We can really make a series out of that. This is what the Message Bible says, of verse 37. Words can be your salvation, or words can also be your damnation.
Yes, sir. That's a fact.
Come on. He says, for by thy words thou shalt be justified. What does that mean? Saved. Free.
not found. Or thy words are you condemned. Proverbs 6:2. Thou art snared, come on, by the words of thy mouth. The word snare means trapped. Come on, if you're feeling claustrophobic in finances this morning, guess what's got you feeling that way? Your confession. Your words. See, my words was trying to trap me, trying to catch me, trying to snare me, thinking that, come on. And see, now that that's happened, when the phone rings now, shoot.
Yeah.
I'm answering that thing like the next one's going to be a $100,000 job.
Yes, yes.
Come on, hold up. I don't care if I ain't got the equipment for it.
My God.
That ain't my problem. Oh, you see what I'm saying? I don't care if I ain't got three trucks right now. That's not my...
Absolutely.
A good man, out of the good deposit in his heart, guess what's going to happen? If they call me tomorrow and got $1 million job for me to do, and I ain't got the equipment in the natural, I just got to get the word of God concerning the promise of God, and I begin to call them things which be not as though they were. I mean, folk, I don't care what your body feels like right now. If you're sick, say, I am healed. Let the weak say, I am strong.
God is strong. Hallelujah.
Come on. Your mouth ain't waiting on God.
No.
Come on. That disease ain't waiting on the spirit of healing. You know what it's waiting on? You to stand back and say, hold up, enough is enough. And anyone that shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed. Come on. It shall not doubt in their heart. Woo, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass. Whatsoever you desire when you pray, believe. When do you believe? When you pray. Not after you pray. When you pray. When you pray. Believe that you receive them and you shall have them. See, the word of God is not a hit or miss thing. It's not a 50. It ain't a slot machine that you just put something in and wonder whether or not you're going to hit the jackpot. But when you release the word.
Oh, hallelujah
to God. Oh, when you release your faith.
Yes.
I say it before. Go on and do something else. Go on to Red Lobster with the kid.
Right.
Come on. Hey, y'all got Disney passes? You got something going on. You go on to say the word of God and go on to take your kids to Disney and get on this a small world and Peter Pan's flight and have you a good old time. Because while you at Disney, the word is working. While you at Red Lobster, the word is working. Hallelujah. 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 10:59. Okay. Note.
For the Lord would say, your mouth will speak these things, because this day I'm shifting thy mind to think these things. Yea, this day my word has become a lever, and I have raised up and cranked up in thy mind these thoughts of no failure, these thoughts of no defeat. Yea, I have elevated thy thinking. I have elevated thy concepts. I have elevated thy vision, saith the Lord. And I place upon thee the anointing of a visionary this day, saith the Lord. And it shall not be a struggle to speak these things, but it shall be a pleasure to say these things. It shall not be a forceful thing, but it shall be a flowing thing that cometh out of thy mouth. For you shall only speak that which I have already elevated thy heart and thy mind to see and to hear this day, saith the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah.
am I trying to say? I'm trying to say the same mess you've talked yourself into. You can talk yourself right out of. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, come on. We think God, come on, we think other people can stop us. We think other people hating on us can stop us. We think the boss man hating on us can stop us. Come on, we think the legislation hating on us can stop us. But can't nobody stop you but you. You're the only one that can stop your progress. You're the only one that can stop your healing. You're the only one that can stop your prosperity. And you do that by your stinking confession. Hallelujah! Come on! I tell you, you want them kids in church? Start making room for them. I mean, don't sit right there. Move over one seat, because a boy, that's where he's going to sit. Come on! I'm saying, hey, you got to make room for the Word of God to come to pass. You got to make room. Mary, Mary, if thou would just believe, you shall see the glory of the Lord. I'll stand up this morning. Hallelujah, son of the Bahia.
Over there in the invisible realm, and you've laid hold of something. something that is immaterial, and now faith makes it materialize over here in this realm. Somebody say, stuff is materializing for me right now. That I've got at in the immaterial realm is materializing by the faith of God right now. You heard me say I'm healed, now watch me run. You heard me say I'm blessed, now watch me write that check and pay that mortgage off. Hallelujah. You heard me say my kids were delivered, now watch them line up at the door and come in. There is a materializing anointing in this room right now. That has been believed for, spoken for, claimed, and laid hold of is now being brought into the material realm. And the Lord wants you to know this morning something big is going on in your midst. Somebody has been stirred up. Something hallowed and holy has woke up on the inside of you. And the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. I said the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. Isn't that what he said to Gideon? And he was over there trembling, trying to thresh wheat in the wine press. And the Holy Ghost said, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. And I'm looking this morning at business owners and entrepreneurs and family membership instead of just one or two. I'm looking at people that own a home and own an automobile and people that have good standing, amen, with the banks and with the community. I'm not looking at struggling people. I'm looking at kings and priests. I will not have a church that is made up of struggling people. You ain't struggling, honey. Whether you know it or not, you've joined up with the right bunch because we don't see nothing but victory. Woo, hallelujah. As Jehovah liveth, strength divine giveth unto them that love him victory all the time. All the time. And there's a materializing anointing. And I don't know just what all will happen before we leave here today. Somebody's actual miracle may materialize before our very eyes this morning. Are you hearing me? Mother may better count her offering twice today, because it just might be more the next time than it was the first time. Oh, glory to God. You might want to check that foot out sometime while you're singing today, because something may just materialize in this room today. Can you say amen? I refuse to sit and look at things that can be. I believe I'll get a Joshua anointing. Moses seen it, but Joshua entered it. And I refuse to see it and not walk in it. I'm going to walk in what I behold. Hallelujah. Everywhere he went, he was doing good. He's a mighty healer. Hallelujah. Everywhere he went.